is the sum of its parts. All the parts are purposeful.
What is a whole?
What is a whole? Good question. What is not a whole? That's my answer. What is not complete? Zoom into the part, a very speck of the part, and how can you say it's not complete? Even if that's all you're seeing is a speck of the leaf, and you can say it's not complete. Complete to what? Compared to what? You know, you zoom out, you're on a tree now, and you say, okay, this is all there is to it, and compared to what? Compared to what? You zoom out again, see two trees. You're like, oh, it's two trees. Oh, it's two trees compared to what? And it goes on and on. And you can go to opposite. You go microscopically into the atoms, say, compared to what?
And it continues?
It should. Intellectually. And even if you were to take your brain out of the picture, said like we should sit here in silence before we start talking, and we're just that. We are just silence.
Silence that makes sound?
We're just silence. And then you zoom that back in with sound, and we're just sounds. If you just listen to the sounds, it's just sounds.
Frequencies.
And even then you see different wave patterns. Up and down. When you zoom out, you just see
static.
When you zoom out, you just see one clear picture. You know? When you zoom more out, then it becomes even more vivid. You zoom in, then you see the distortion. So the opposites.
So everything is a whole? We are a whole.
We are a whole. You can do a lot of imaginative exercises. Feel and see. You can describe as what you want to describe it. How it. Because you are measuring a different part. You're measuring a difference in the whole. Not a different part. You're measuring a difference because you're already a part. I don't think you can necessarily measure another part. Like a tree can't measure me. You know? And can I really measure a tree? Measure in terms of, do I really understand the tree? Does the tree really understand me? My part is to think I understand the tree. That's my part. And I'll do all the things that within me to make more trees, or I can make wood out of trees, or I can burn trees for energy. Can eat the fruits off the trees. That's what I have in me. All of those functionalities are my tools. Are my tool. Every one of us does that with our tool in various degrees. The tree pollinates, it gets chlorophyll, it makes oxygen. All of that is within the tree. And you look at a human. I have all that capacity. I can't make oxygen. And I have to get it from trees.
Do the trees depend on on us?
Yes, the trees need our carbon dioxide. That's the connection.
So just because they're not a moving form, don't mean that they're not life. They are life.
Yeah, it's alive. Life, because we know it has chemical functions, that energy moving through it. We know that it's not static energy when it falls. Energy is in motion. Energy is connected versus when energy is gone. The energies get compacted when it dies. And you burn the wood, and the energy is released again. It goes up in smoke. And smoke becomes water. Water comes back down. And it cycle goes around. And that's the whole. Whole is cycles. Holes are cycles.
Every cycle becomes part.
Yes. And a cycle can be a part as well.
Wow.
Because everything is
a whole, a part.
A part of the whole. So within the cycle, you'll see elements of the tree, elements of humanity, elements of the earth, universe, stars. If we were to examine that carefully, you will find the whole is in the parts. The parts are purposeful. So what is your purpose?
Part of the whole. In the moment, being part of reality, being me, being a tree is a tree, and it remains a tree. A human is a human, and it remains a human. We do human stuff, human things. But as my part of doing is simply just living, enjoying, growing. Messing up, learning from it, just being part of the solution, or I could be part of the problem. Everything has a part. Every individual, every being that surrounds us that we see has a part. And my part is just to simply enjoy it. Simply live it. Simply just let everything come. Accept it. What it is and what we can make it.
Yeah, I fully understand that. You have purposed living. Your purpose is to live. And living is all encompassing. Because you've actualized your life. Using your life as your tool. How I live is how I live.
How I enjoy is how I enjoy.
How I enjoy is how I enjoy.
It's crazy because sometimes we get lost in trying. I say trying because we try our best to do something that we're not. To try to stand out or try to just something that's not us. When in reality, all we just do is live the moment.
In reality, you should be your reality. Meaning, what is it you're telling yourself in the moment? Living, you said. Live. Just live. That's your tool. You said it's your tool. Your purpose is to live. And how you live is how you live. You don't want to imagine otherwise. And imagining otherwise means you are something that's not current. Something you don't, you're not living. Go back to that word living. Something you're not living. It's not your reality, you said. So you focus on what is your reality. And if you want to get deep and comfortable with the fact that your reality might not be feel those layers of reality. You can stay with the physical, what you see right in front of you, what you feel right in front of you. You can go deeper see your dreams and see your imaginative creation. And you can go above that.
Visualize.
And be in that realm. Not visualize it, but you're actually existing in that imaginative space where you get to life, your full life, your full total capability. And that's where you're aiming towards, you're building towards. Because everything you say about life means life. Purpose is and what your tool is, as you said, life.
Is there like a purpose? Like we confuse purpose from like a cheap from like having money or being in somewhere you see yourself, and purpose from just being you.
Again, you gotta be brought up. Many you brought up imaginative tools, money, success, right? Those are emotional, imaginative tools. The word success connotates a very abundant completion. Go back to the word completion. Success imagines completion. You finish your goal, you finish your task. So that's the idea. It's a completion. Going back, so you become attached to that separate imaginative creation. You absorb something that cannot be absorbed because it's its own tool. It's its own completion. And here you are, complete life purpose, and you're merging a imaginative purpose of success, which is impossible, right? Grabbing onto it. It's like I'll try to grab this tree. Take it with me. Here I am dragging this tree around. Or even dragging around, even trying to uproot it. Imagine that, me uprooting this tree. By myself, my bare hands, my thoughts and my spirit. I'm trying to grab it. That's what you do with all these separate tools. Success. Try to hold on to it. But it's a separate part. It's an imaginative part.
It's not us.
It's not us. It's our imaginative creative. But by us creating it, it becomes a part of the whole. Because we created it, right? But it's not us. It's a separate creation. It's like a bicycle we created. That's separate from us now. It came out of thin air. Pull all of these parts together. And each part is separate. The wheel is its own separate thing. And a hole too. And the chains, you know, and the rubber. All of that separate. The metal, the plastic. But they all combine to make a bicycle. If you zoom in again, you get the seat, you get the wheels, you get the spokes, you get the chain. If you zoom further in, you get the metal. And each one of those has a purpose for the bicycle. But they're not the bicycle. And that's what we do with success. And all these things we create that are created, that are creations. I want success. I need to hold on to it. I need to grab it. I need to take it. You know?
Because they're complete, knowing that we're already complete.
We're already complete.
We're already a whole.
And you're trying to become something that you can't become. Which is successful, which is a whole in itself. You can only be next to success. You can only create it and let it go. You create success, it goes. It lives by itself. You know? You create something that's separate from you. If you merge success, then it's an illusion you're creating. had yourself before the success. You felt that emotion. You felt that joy, that whatever, pride, all in you. And now you've created this new thing, success, which is separate. Which is like you having a baby. You create a baby that's separate from you.
Just part of you.
There's a connection you have, but it doesn't mean you're that thing. You're connected to it because you created it. You have molecules in it. You're a part of it. It's not a part of you, right? Because you are just an element in the success. Success is operating you. Or you can say it opposite too. Success is an element in you. You can do either word, but either way, you are not your fingernail, right?
No, it's part of it.
It's part of you.
It makes me. It makes the hand.
Exactly. And the fingernail is not you. Vice versa, the same with success. You know, something out of you isn't necessarily you. You know, your hair isn't you. You know, it's part of you, right? And those are the things. You look at confusions we create. Saying, why don't you use your brain? Somebody would say. You can't stop using your brain. If you're alive with this tool of life, your brain is kicking, your brain is working. Why don't you think? Just start thinking. You can't help but think. You're thinking, you know. But the short is kind of derogatory, telling you you're not using your brain or you're not thinking, which is just a control factor of saying, I want you thinking like this. I want you using your brain for this, you know. So, yeah.
Yeah, many people. They judge you based on what they know?
Always. They measure you. It's a measurement. And they can use their measurement for accuracy or to distort. Just like any tool, you know? You can measure things as a tool. You fail, you go to hit a hammer, you have a hammer, you go to hit the nail, and you hit your thumb. You know, it's inaccuracy. Then hit the nail. Or the hammer loses the handle. You can't really hit it that much, you know?
Wow. So everything that makes a part, it's important.
Yes. It's important unto itself, and it's important in the whole. Because without that part, the whole wouldn't be a whole. It'd be incomplete. And that's not functional. Something that's incomplete. It just becomes incomplete, which is a different state of completion, right? Which is a whole too. It's its own thing, but it needs completion to be really purposeful. not really purposeful, but to be whole, right? Because incomplete with complete makes a whole, right? Complete means incomplete, because it's complete to what? And then together, they become the whole. They cancel each other out. Or not really cancel each other out, but they become the whole. In a sense, they settle onto the frame, creates the bicycle, you know? All you have is a bicycle without a saddle. That's not really a bicycle.
We gotta accept that we are a whole. We are part of this reality. So instead of seeking other things outside of yourself, you have to accept me. I have to accept who we are. Accept that we're part of it. And just,
yes.
Flow.
Acceptance. You accept that you are a part, but you're not. You're purposeful. You don't think you're insignificant. Now, if you think you're insignificant, you become an insignificant part, and that is purposeful. You're not canceling out your purpose. You just created a new purpose by being insignificant. You become an insignificant purpose, because compared to a purposeful, significant person, you're the opposite. Because without, exactly, without that significant person, there's no such thing as insignificant. So you are purposeful, and you can easily become significant because you just created yourself into an insignificant purpose. Everything you do is a purpose.
We are the purpose.
Everything you do is the purpose. And it's hard and it's easy sometimes.
It's challenging. It's part of the program. It's part of reality. System.
It is, you can say, in short. You can say it is. Because after anything after that, you complicate. It is. And it is complicated in itself, because you're like, what is? Then you start thinking in your head, what is? You know, you start going through, how can it be this way? You start adding questions to it.
Is that harmful? Just staying in your head, or just thinking and thinking and thinking?
Yes, it's harmful. Everything can be harmful. It's not necessary with moderation. Moderation is the idea for limitation. But you can go to extremes and achieve a certain peace if you are purposeful in that aspect. Because the extreme, the moderate, the two extremes in the center are all within the what is. Each slide back and forth. You can go from the center to an extreme to either edges. And you become, just like I said, you become either significant or insignificant. But each end of the spectrum deserves a purpose, has a purpose. You just slide from one end to the next. Or you stay in one end to the next. You stay moderate or you stay extreme. And you live that way. Die that way, also.
You make me complicate our purpose. You complicate our lives sometimes by just going outside of us. Why do you think people not know this? That you are part of it?
They do. They do know it. Not on the physical sometimes, not on the emotional. I mean, spiritual, they do know. And if you take them just at their physical, you'll see that they don't know. You perceive that they don't know. And again, you just have to, you have to utilize all your layers to see their whole. If you are seeking to see their whole, if you're seeking to see that they're not whole, you'll see that, because you'll be on the layer that's communicating to you that you're measuring to be incomplete, right? So if you're trying to be the tool within you that measures for wholeness, you will find the right part to measure, and you will see that it's whole. It makes them whole. That's judgment. You're using different tools. Judgment is a tool. And if you measure it correctly, you will judge correctly.
So everything that we consider bad could be used in a great way?
Yes. Everything bad has some good in it. Everything good has some bad in it. So, and that's where you get the whole, good and the bad.
Balance.
Yeah, so if you keep looking at that bad thing that you think is incomplete, you're missing the complete opposite of it. You're missing the part that makes it complete. And most of us don't do that. Sometimes it's hard. Sometimes the completion is just a speck of dust on the hair. A speck of dust on that person's hair. You're trying to determine if it's complete, if it's a good part. But it's difficult, right?
We don't know that.
It's very difficult to find that speck of hope, speckle of life, speckle of truth within those lies. You know, it's very difficult, very, very difficult. Wow. I mean, I'll look into it. You're just measuring. You don't want to use your tool to measure. All you're measuring is one thing. You're measuring the bad. You're getting a lot of information that is bad. You keep, you know, it tells you that, okay, this is the whole. But all your tools to detect wholeness. You use the spirit, you're using emotions and physical dimensions, dimensional tools, and then you fail to use the spirit.
That's the most important thing.
Well, I'd say it's most important. It just completes the measurement, right?
So nothing is more important than the other. It's just all combined.
Again, compared to what? If you're comparing them, you're comparing two different purposes, right? So you're doing something that's within the whole, that's separating and differentiating by comparing, but you're also knowing that they are purposeful against each other. Even you measuring it that way is purposeful. So it's a matter of just shifting through your tools, man. Open up your toolbox. Do I have the right tool here? Am I measuring it correctly? You know, am I using a spray paint to bang some hammer?
Strokes on you? Well, that's when you gotta measure it. Because we don't want trouble. Well, maybe we do. So we could learn something from that.
Exactly. But you know that you're not doing the purpose, right? That and even you not doing the purpose is the purpose. Like you purposefully made a purpose not to have a purpose, going back to insignificance, right?
Wow.
So that's the idea, man. Use the right tool with use the right purpose tool. You know,
connection. Wow. It's crazy because I didn't really pay attention to this until like recently started seeing the real connection. And it amazes me because everything you think, do, or say comes up to you. It shows up in front of you.
Yeah, the tool. The tool is purpose. Our tool is purpose. We have purpose. Each and every one. Everything we do has purpose. Everything has purpose. Everything you do combines into the whole. Every creation, every thought, everything, every movement, every inaction, everything goes into that. And your nothingness becomes it as well. Indecisiveness. You become alive. Become a truth. Become alive, man. You want to be only truthful. You know, you want to only tell lies. You want to get rid of lies. All of that is purpose. All of that.
There's times that we all avoid that.
That's purpose. That's a different purpose, right? Yeah. But it's incomplete because you know it's split. You know you're split until you become that whole disillusional thing. And that's a purpose too. You become disillusional. Misguided. You know? That's a purpose. Once you're aware of it, it's more likely for you to shift into another purpose. Once you're aware of it, it becomes more likely that you're going to shift. Because you say, I am purposeless now. And that's the awareness of purposelessness. So you know what purpose is now. Once you're aware of who you are, I know I'm a human being. I know there's a tree over there. I know differences now. I know I can't be a tree. I know I can be only me. You know? I know for me to be a tree, I will have to go through a whole bunch of transformation that I don't even know how to get to, but I know it requires that. I have to change from me to a tree. So when you know who you are, that you know your purpose, and you're able to shift gears, and you know what it would take to shift gears. purpose recognizing purpose.
Big purpose in there.
Purpose, recognizing purpose, and then understanding where you could merge or where you can shift. The tree right now is possibly thinking about becoming a human. But that's my imagination. I just created that. You know?
We have a purpose.
We have purpose.
We have purpose. It's okay to feel lost. It's okay. Wander around. So that's when you find yourself. When you live your purpose. Wow. There's moments like this that when we're having a conversation, it opens up my mind more, and I get stuck in comprehending it. But it brings more things to it. It brings.
Don't just write it. Don't care if you verbalize it. Just write it. Just write it. Don't memorize it. Don't memorize it either. If it comes back to you, it comes back to you. Just let it flow. Don't, even if you try to memorize it, you will know it, or you won't know it. You'll memorize it, and then the importance will shift, because you'll be, something else will demand your attention. So you need to ride that as well. And if that comes back again, it was meant to be, the brain swirls it around, here you are, you have it. The importance, the purpose comes back when you speak it now, you know, when you explain it. And you keep repeating it. It becomes you. It doesn't become you, but you have fully created that thing. It's now a separate, purposeful creation. And that's how it goes. Right on.
Thank you. Living this purpose, enjoying it, and growing just like you. Thank you, Milton. Appreciate it. Thank you for this moment. Thank you for opening up these doors and just going with the flow. Thank you for this connection. That we actually took time to come here and just stay in the moment. There's so much that goes on through our day that we don't. Personally, I don't really take the time to actually just stay still and like this. And there's moments like this that I make excuses to not do it. But when those excuses come in, I just say, I look into them and actually say, no, I can't. I don't let that stop me from actually coming down here and just being present. Just simply enjoying this moment. And this is where I actually find myself a little bit more every time. From those 2 times. This is the second time. But it actually helps me out to be in the moment. Gracias.
Right on, brother. Indeed.
Thank you, guys. Have a good one. Let's keep living this purpose. You are a purpose. You are magnificent. You are what you are.
Love always now.